Salutations, celestial sightseers. David Fuller here with Eyes on the Sky. I have read over 100 books on astronomy, trying to find the perfect book that has all the things that I want in it and none of the things that I don't want in it. And that usually consists of being able to quickly identify what I want to see in a given part of the sky, because I know that the object will be bright enough for me to be able to see, or maybe is of a bright enough, faint object, but bright enough that I can find it, see it, or photograph it, and that it has information about it that allows me to know, can I see it in this given eyepiece? Can I see it with this given telescope? Can I be able to photograph it with this given photographic equipment? While stellarium, which I have used extensively in my videos, is a great tool for finding out a lot of information, such as that it doesn't do a good job of sorting it for you so that you can find exactly what you want, because there's thousands of things in there. So you have to keep going and looking and looking and looking and looking, and that can take a long time. So if you want to be able to find it quickly, there is a book for that. And it's a book I wish I had written. And not only is this book written, but it's done better than I could have done it. So let me ask you a few questions. If these would appeal to you, would you want a book that has the following? 500 deep space objects, 250 binary stars to at least 6 magnitude, 80 variable stars with a maximum magnitude of 6 or brighter, stars to a magnitude of 3.5 or brighter with detailed information on every single star 3.5 magnitude or brighter. Importantly for me, the surface brightness at a glance for every single deep space object listed in the book. Ordered star charts that are to a standard scale, and finder charts for the best DSOs that are also to a standard scale, and where those finder charts are on the larger map for a given constellation. Photos of every single deep space object with a scale on it, so it's easy to know if the object can be imaged or what eyepiece to use, and notes for visual observers for binoculars and a 6-inch telescope. Plus, there's more than that. So what is this book that has all that information, is clear, relatively concise, and is easy to use? It is The Observer's Sky Atlas by Erich Karkoschka. And I'm telling you, this book, I wish I had written it. Or if nothing else, that I had maybe an Excel spreadsheet or something that had all the information that this book contains. Because it is so easy to use, whether you are doing visual or astrophotography, astronomy, this book has all the stuff that you need to be able to get great visual looks at the best objects that are out there, or take photos of them. So let me just show you a little bit about what some of is in this book. For example, he has written not only what each star chart will be and where it generally is in the sky, because he gives you a small chart with context so you know where the smaller chart is, or the larger chart is, I should say, on the opposite page, plus where each of the finder charts are within that. And every single star that is listed on the pages also is listed over in the table on the other side. So you have all the information about every single one of those stars, and you've got all the information for every single deep space object that is over there, or deep sky object that's over there. They all match. There's nothing that you would find on this page that's not also on this page. It all correlates, which is wonderful, because I can't tell you how many books I have read where it says, oh, NGC 3224 is over here. And I go, great, what's that? I mean, I know it's a galaxy, but it's not over on this other page. This book does not miss anything. It just has all the stuff that you need to be able to observe, photograph, whatever. Plus, he explains all of it in the first part of it. Everything is brief and succinct, giving you enough information without overdoing it. And in the back, there's a bunch of tables So you know exactly what everything is. There's nebula numbers, appendices, there's additional charts for things. It is really, there are probably 3 or 4 books that I reference regularly when I try to do Eyes on the Sky videos. I've got a book for the moon. I have one for yearly sky events. And I have a couple that I reference for what to find in the night sky. And this absolutely is going to be part of that stable going forward, because it's going to be easy for me to be able to take outside or look at what I want to be able to see, write them down, go outside and observe, or go outside and take a photo of it, because it's just that good of a book. It's really hard for me to say enough good things about it. Plus, Erich Karkoschka has done, I'm just going to give you a little bit of information about him here on the screen so you can see. He knows what he's talking about. Plus, he's done all the observing. He's observed every single object in here with his own 6-inch telescope and his own binoculars. I'm going to really highly recommend that you consider getting this book if you want something that will cover all those bases for you. It really just has everything that I've always wanted in a book, and I'd always wish I'd written in a book. And maybe it's what you want to, and if so, check it out. It's by Firefly Publications, and definitely worth considering. Thanks for watching. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up, including all the 500 objects in this book. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.